Hey, what's up? Welcome back to another video. If you're new to my channel, my name is Mattia. I am a professional time-lapse and hyperlapse photographer living in Madrid. Today, I want to show you how to use a plugin that I've been using for at least 10 years. This plugin has pushed the quality of my time-lapse to the next level. Hope you're doing well, and thanks Knit Video for sponsoring today's tutorial. This plugin is available for pretty much every editing software out there: After Effects, Premiere Pro, Final Cut, DaVinci, Vegas, and even more. For the past 10 years, I've been using it in After Effects for two main reasons: removing noise and sharpening time lapses. I've tried all the options for noise reduction and sharpening in the past, and even now I think there is nothing that works as well as Knit Video. Thanks to this plugin, I've been able to capture high ISO time lapses and remove all the noise to get clean and sharp footage. So let's jump to the computer and I'll show you how I use it. As an example, I want to show you a time lapse I shot of the Northern Light on October 11th here in Madrid. I still can't believe that I shot something like this. Normally when shooting the Northern Lights in places like Iceland or Norway, I'd use a 2 second exposure with a 3 second interval. But here in Spain, I use a 6 second exposure and an 8 second interval. So with these settings and shooting at night, I had to crank up the ISO. Otherwise, I wouldn't have seen much. In this case, I use ISO 6400 and the Sony A7 R3. And as you can see, the noise is pretty visible. Now, let me show you how easy it is to get rid of the noise. Once I am on After Effects, on the effect panel, search for Knit Video and drag and drop it onto your video. To get the best result, make sure to change the resolution to full. Click prepare and a pop-up menu will appear. Ah, a pro tip here, go to tool, preference, performance and click optimize settings. So Knit Video can optimize itself to your computer. Then go back and click auto profile. Knit Video will select an area of your frame where it thinks it's best to take as a reference for denoising. If the square is over the stars, change it manually and select an area without visible stars to avoid the blurriness. Now go to Adjust and Preview and you'll see the magic of Knit Video. With just one click, the time lapse is denoised. It usually does a fantastic job with the default settings, but if you want to adjust them, you can do it on the right panel. You can tweak the temporal and spatial filter here. With the temporal section, you can also deflicker time lapses or remove satellites from Astro time lapses with the dust and scratch tool. Check out my other video for more on that. If you want even more settings to tweak, switch to advanced mode here. You will have plenty of options to play with. And in the Adjust and Preview panel, click on Filter Setting Check. And here you have more detailed information about the noise and the flicker on your time-lapse. Once I'm happy with the noise reduction, I switch to the second page to enable sharpening. I always turn off sharpening in my camera because I prefer to add it on during post-production. And after trying different software, Knit Video is constantly giving me the best result. I recommend experiment a bit with the slider to see what works for your frame. I usually set the fine slider to around 45-50%. Click apply and that's it. You now got a clean and sharp time lapse. I can't recommend this plugin enough. If you're into time lapse photography and want the best result, this is an investment that will pay off. You can try out by downloading a demo for free on their website, and it's a one-time payment product, which I love. The pro version is 130 euro, and while there is a cheaper version, it's limited to 1080p and can be used for commercial work. Thank you again, Knit Video, for sponsoring this video. If you ended up trying out, drop a comment and let me know how it worked for you. I love seeing your time-lapse creation. Subscribe if you haven't already, and see you in the next one. Ciao, ciao.